Hello everyone. So in last lecture, we discuss about concept of factorial experiment, and then we discuss about two square factorial experiment. And for this experiment, we find main effect and interaction effect. So in today's lecture, we are going to discuss statistical analysis of two square factorial experiment, which is arranged in randomized block design. So let us discuss about this concept. So in two square design, we have four treatment combinations. So one is, first is 1A, B and AB. So what 1 represents? 1 is the factor A at first level and factor B at first level. Then A denotes factor A at second level and factor B at first level. Treatment combination B represents factor A at first level and factor B at second level, and this AB denotes A and B, both factors at second level. So here we discuss layout through randomized block design. So we know that in randomized block design, we consider T number of treatments and we consider B number of blocks, and we divide our whole experimental material into B blocks, and each block we divide into T number of experimental units, and after that we assign treatments randomly in that experimental unit. So similar layout we use here for two square design, which is arranged in randomized block design. So our first step is divide the experimental material into R homogeneous blocks. So when our experimental material is heterogeneous in nature, so first we divide that material into R homogeneous blocks. Then our second step is divide each block into four experimental units. So in two square design, we have four treatment combinations, 1A, B and AB. So we want to divide each block or R blocks into four experimental units. And in third step, we apply these four treatment combinations in each block randomly. So here we get different number of blocks. Okay. So this is our first block, and we divide this first block into four experimental units. So here we assign our treatment combinations randomly. So here we assign AB, 1A and B. Similarly, in block 2 also, we assign these four treatment combinations randomly. So here we assign AB, then B, A and 1. So similarly, in R block, Rth block, we assign these treatment combinations randomly, AB, B, 1 and A. So in this way, we get a two square factorial design in randomized block design. In this way, we get a layout for this design. Then hypothesis testing. So here we test different hypotheses. Our first hypothesis is there is no significant difference between block effects. So here we consider block effects, that is homogeneous blocks, and we want to test there is a significant difference. Is there is a significant difference between block effects or not? Versus our alternative is H01, H11. At least two block effects are differ significantly. So with the help of ANOVA table, if we reject our H01, then our interest is to test which two block effects are differ significantly. Then our second hypothesis is for main effect A. So our hypothesis is H02, main effect A is not significant, versus alternative is H12, main effect A is significant. So this hypothesis is for main effect of factor A. Then third hypothesis is for main effect B. H03 is main effect B is not significant, versus alternative is H13, main effect B is significant. Then fourth hypothesis is for interaction effect. So hypothesis is H04, interaction effect AB is not significant, versus alternative is H14, interaction effect AB is significant. So in this way, we test these four hypotheses in our 2 square factorial design which is arranged in RBD. Then we will discuss, so in last lecture we discussed treatment totals and treatment means. So we consider square bracket, that square bracket represent treatment totals. So in 2 square factorial design we have 4 treatment totals. Treatment total for first treatment combination 1, it is denoted by square bracket 1, square bracket A, square bracket B and square bracket AB. So these 4 are the treatment totals. Now we want to find factorial effects total. Okay, so here we have main effect A, main effect B and interaction effect AB. So for these 3 terms we want to find factorial effect total. So for factor A, factorial effect total is denoted by square bracket capital A, and it is square bracket AB plus A minus B minus 1. So this is factorial effect total for factor A. Okay, so it is denoted by square bracket capital A. Now how to remember this formula? So we know that main effect for factor A is capital A, which is half average of treatment combination AB minus B plus A minus 1. So when we consider square bracket, it represents treatment totals. When we consider open bracket, it represents treatment mean. So here we know formula for main effect A. So here only replace this treatment means by its treatment total. Suppose we replace this AB treatment mean by its treatment total, then it is square bracket AB minus square bracket B plus square bracket A minus square bracket 1. So this term is nothing but our treatment factorial effect total, AB plus B minus B, sorry, plus A minus B minus 1. So in this way we remember this factorial effect total. Then second term is, or second factorial effect total is for factor B, and it is square bracket B, it is square bracket AB minus treatment total for treatment A, then B treatment total and treatment total for treatment combination 1. So this is formula for factorial effect total. And how to remember this formula? So we know that main effect for factor B, so main effect for factor B is only, suppose we denote this by factor B. So that term is only this, AB plus B, and here we have minus A and minus 1. Okay. So here we consider plus B and here we have minus B. This is the formula for main effect AB. So in this case, replace this open bracket or replace this treatment means by its treatment total, so that we get factorial effect total for factor B. So this is formula for factorial effect total for factor B. Then next is factorial total for interaction effect AB. So it is denoted by square bracket AB, and it is treatment total for AB minus treatment total of treatment combination A minus B plus 1. And to remember this formula, first remember interaction effect AB. So what is interaction effect AB? It is half of A minus 1 into B minus 1. And that term is right here. That term is AB minus B minus A and plus 1. Okay, so only replace this treatment means by its treatment total. So we get this term, treatment factorial effect total. Okay, so this is about factorial effect total. Now we will discuss how to find a sum of squares in 2 square factorial design. Okay, so our first is total sum of square. So total sum of square is denoted by SST. And it is summation over I, summation over j, xij minus x dot dot bar bracket square. So there I represent treatment. So here we have 4 treatment combinations and j is running from 1 to r, since we have r number of blocks. And what is Xij? Xij is the observation due to ith treatment and jth block. And x dot dot bar is our grand mean, bracket square. So to find sum of square, so when we solve any example, we use that simple formula which we discussed in a randomized block design, that is summation Xij square minus grand correction factor, and correction factor is grand total square upon total number of observation. So this is about sum of square due to total. Then next is sum of square due to blocks. Okay, so sum of square due to blocks is denoted by SSB, and it is summation over I summation over j x dot j bar minus x dot dot bar bracket square. So what is x dot j bar? It is jth block mean, and we know that this term is independent of I. Okay, so this SSB can be written as summation over j into 4 in bracket x dot j bar minus x dot dot bar bracket square, or it can be written as summation over j x dot j square upon 4 minus correction factor. Okay, so when we find a block sum of square for any problem or in any problem, then we use that simple formula which we have already discussed in randomized block design. Then next term is sum of square for factor A. Okay, so sum of square for factor A is denoted by SS to the base capital A, and it is square of factorial effect total for factor A upon total number of observations. So suppose we have, so here we have 4 number of treatments and R number of replicates, so it is 4 into R. So total number of observation is 4 into R. So this is formula for sum of square for factor A. Then second is sum of square due to factor B, and it is factorial effect total for factor B square upon 4R, that is square bracket B square upon 4 into R. And then for interaction effect, sum of square due to interaction effect is denoted by SS to the base capital AB, and it is a square of factorial effect total for AB upon 4 into R, that is total number of observation. So these are the formulas for sum of squares. Now to find sum of square due to error, we use that expression. Sum of square due to total is sum of square due to block, sum of square due to treatment plus sum of square due to error. So with the help of this formula, we can find out sum of square for error. Now this is ANOVA table for two square factorial design when we arrange this design in randomized block design with R replicates. Okay, so here we have 5 columns in this ANOVA table. So first column represents sources of variation. So in sources of variation, we have block effect, main effect A, main effect B, then interaction effect AB, error and total. Second column is for degrees of freedom. So when we consider R replicates, for block effects, our degrees of freedom is R minus 1. Then for main effect and interaction effect, our degrees of freedom is 1. So here for main effect A, it is 1. For main effect B, it is 1. And for interaction effect AB, it is 1. Then for error, so in RBD, we know that error degrees of freedom is T minus 1 into B minus 1. So in two square factorial design, T means number of treatments. So here we have 4 treatment combinations. So T minus 1, that is 4 minus 1 is 3. So here is 3 into R minus 1. And total degrees of freedom means capital N minus 1. So in RBD, capital N means total number of observation is T into B. So here we have T equals to 4, and B is nothing but our number of replications, that is number of blocks. So total degrees of freedom is 4R minus 1. Then third column is for sum of squares. So this sum of square for block effect is denoted by SSB, and we have already discussed formula to find SSB. Then for main effect A, it is SSA, then SS capital B. For interaction effect, it is SS capital AB. For error, it is SSE, and for total, it is SS capital T. So with the help of these sum of squares, we find mean sum of squares. So for block effect, mean sum of square is denoted by MSB, and it is ratio of sum of square due to block upon its degrees of freedom R minus 1. Then for main effect A, it is denoted by MS to the base capital A, and it is SSA upon 1. So when we consider this factorial designs, mean sum of square for main effect and interaction effect and sum of squares are equal since degrees of freedom is 1 for all main effect and interaction effects. So here we get mean sum of square for main effect A is sum of square due to main effect A. Then mean sum of square for factor B, it is SSB sum of square due to main effect B upon its degrees of freedom 1. Then for interaction effect AB, it is denoted by MS to the base AB, and it is SSAB upon 1. Then MSE. So MSE is mean sum of square due to error, and it is SSE, that is sum of square due to error, upon its degrees of freedom 3 into R minus 1. So with the help of this mean sum of squares, we find variance ratio to test above 4 hypotheses. So for block effect A, we denote variance ratio by F to the base B, and it is ratio of mean sum of square due to block effect upon mean sum of square due to error. And this follows F distribution with block effect degrees of freedom and error degrees of freedom. Then for main effect A, variance ratio is denoted by capital F to the base capital A, and it is MSA upon MSE, that is ratio of mean sum of square due to main effect A upon mean sum of square due to error. Then for main effect B, it is denoted by F to the base capital B, and it is MSB upon SSE, that is ratio of mean sum of square due to main effect B upon mean sum of square due to error. And for interaction effect, variance ratio is denoted by capital F to the base AB, and it is MSAB upon MSE, that is ratio of mean sum of square due to factor due to interaction effect AB upon mean sum of square due to error. So this is about ANOVA table. Now how we test our hypothesis, or when we reject our hypothesis? So here we have conclusions about our hypothesis. So if our first F ratio for block effect FB is greater than critical value, then we reject our H01 at given alpha percent level of significance. That is, there is a significant difference between block effects. And critical value for this is F with block degrees of freedom and error degrees of freedom with given alpha percent level of significance. So this is conclusion for our first hypothesis. Then if our F to the base capital A is greater than critical value, then we reject our second hypothesis H02 at given alpha percent level of significance. That is, main effect A is significant, and critical value for this is F with 1 and error degrees of freedom at given alpha percent level of significance. This is a conclusion for second hypothesis. Then for third hypothesis, if our FB is greater than critical value, then we reject our third hypothesis, that is H03, at given alpha percent level of significance. So our third hypothesis is H03, main effect B is not significant. So if we reject hypothesis, it means that our main effect B is significant, and critical value for this is F with 1 and 3 into R minus 1 degrees of freedom. Then our fourth conclusion for our fourth hypothesis is if F with AB is greater than critical value, and critical value is F with 1 and 3 into R minus 1 degrees of freedom, then we reject our H04 at given alpha percent level of significance. Our H04 is interaction effect AB is not significant. So if we reject this hypothesis, then we accept our alternative hypothesis, that is interaction effect AB is significant. So this is conclusion about our hypothesis, and this concept is statistical analysis of two square factorial design when we arrange this design in our randomized block design. Thank you.